This chunky basket weave cushion looks lovely in light and airy Scandinavian style decor, but it goes equally well with a more colorful style. This here image is in my own home. Here we see what it looks like from close by. To make it, we alternate front and back post trebles. That's what creates the checkered look, and it's easy to make. Hi, I'm Tuula, and I'm with you for this tutorial. So let's start. You need some type of a fairly chunky yarn. I'm using this here cotton twine that comes in large cones. The cushion took a little bit more than one of these here cones. This one is from Finland, but you can check the video description for a similar kind that's available in many parts of the world. And I was using a crochet hook size 5 mm. You could also use 6. Very recently, I published this here video where I show the technique of these large squares of basket weave in detail. So here I'm not explaining the same things again, but I'm showing how I made the cushion. So if you need to, you can go to the other video at any time and then come back here again. The link is here in the top corner and also in the video description. What you need first is a long, fairly loose chain. Each square is 8 stitches, and because every other square needs to be different, that's 16. For the size of a cushion that I'm making, 40 times 40 centimeters or 16 times 16 inches, you need 6 squares on each side using this here yarn. So that makes that you need to chain 96. Here I have chained 96, and then bring the start and the end of the chain together and make sure not to twist it. If you want a great easy tip on how not to twist your chains, check out tip number 5 on this here video. Then close it into a ring using a slip stitch. For the first round, we just need to treble into each stitch. First chain 4. And then start making trebles into every stitch. Treble using the American term. In British terms, it's a double treble. 2 yarn overs and each stitch. Right round every stitch. When you have that done, close the round using a slip stitch, and then we start the squares, and then chain 3. You won't be making a front or back post on top of these here chains, but then always start with the first one. But this counts as one. So now you will need first to have 7 front post trebles. And again here, like I mentioned earlier, there's the other video that explains this more in detail. 8 stitches like this, counting this here chain. Front posts. And after that, 8 back post ones. So here's 8 counting the chains, and then you switch over for back posts one. So you take the stitch from the back and 8 of these again. So this is how you continue the whole cushion. 8 front posts and 8 back posts. On the other video, I'm working back and forth, so there you need to turn. But with this here cushion, you work in the round and you never turn. You always work from the same side. And when you finish a round, I've one finished here. Then always just the same, that you finish off with a slip stitch and chain three, and then continue whichever kind of stitch you need. So here it's a front post, but if it was already further on and I would need to change to the other type, then I would start with the back post here. And that's how we continue. And here's a close-up of what it looks like. And the easiest way to count your rounds is counting these horizontal lines. You always have four of those. Okay, this is big enough now. It's square, like that. And when you are finished, I would leave about three times the length of it of yarn and sew it up with that. Or you could, of course, sew a zip on it. But I decided not to, because it's such a big and bulky thing. I'm going to sew it up with large stitches and then put a pillow inside it and then sew the other end too. Done! It will look great whatever style of home you have, and you can make several in different colors. Also, check out this other video for making lovely things for your home.